This video will show you how to set page numbers and create footnotes for a paper written in Chicago note bibliography style using Google Drive. Okay, so I've got a title page here because my paper is more than 5 pages long. And if I have a title page, there's a special way to do the page numbers in Chicago. So I've double-clicked to open up my header. I'm turning off different first page. And then I go to Insert, Header and Page Number, Page Number. And then I click this one on the top right that has no number on the title page and starts numbering the first page of text with the number 1. Okay, that's what it should look like in Chicago style. Now I can double click onto my document to open that part up. And now let's look at a citation. So what I've got here is a citation in MLA format, which a lot of students are more familiar with. According to researchers Amy Brown and Michelle Lee, a restrictive maternal child feeding style has been linked with increased levels of eating in the absence of hunger, and 108 is the page number. Now, in Chicago style, I'm going to use a footnote instead of a parenthetical citation like this. Now, on this paper, I have a bibliography page at the end. That has the more detailed information, the publication information about the source. So I don't need the kind of long detailed footnotes that you might see on the Al Perdue website. I can use a shortened version. So let's go up here and do that. So what I want to do is I put my cursor right here after the period and I click Insert Footnote. Okay, so that automatically takes me down to the bottom of the page and it numbers them automatically for me. I typed the author's name. This has two authors, so I'll type them both. And then I need the title of the article. I don't need the whole title. The first 3 or 4 words is just fine. So I'll just copy that. Then I do comma, quotation mark, and that was page 108, and a period. Okay, so let's go back up to this part with a footnote and fix this. So since we're not doing MLA format, we don't need the page number here. And since we don't have the parenthetical citation, the period should go before the quotation mark. So it's period, quotation mark, number. Now let's look down at the formatting of the footnote at the bottom here. So there's a problem with the font here. So we will highlight this and we'll make sure that all of it is in Times New Roman. And we can use 10 points. It's a little bit smaller for the footnotes. We can also see that it's right next to it, single spaced with the next citation. So we can go to Format and Line Spacing and add space after paragraph to space those out. We also want to indent this. And so if we click on it and we come up here to the ruler, we drag the left indent over to the half inch mark. And that fixes it. We've got the author, the title, and the page number. So to recap, you add a page number from the Insert menu, choose the option that has no page number on the first page, then you click Insert to insert the footnote, then on the bottom you write the author, the title, and the page number separated with commas, and then you adjust the font and the indent. I hope that helps.